Viruses are fascinating because they're so tiny, and somehow it comes in and it really hijacks the host cell. It's really interesting how it's able to do that. I think those are fundamental questions that we don't understand and are very important, because viruses will always be around and they'll always be a threat to human health. Growing up in Bulgaria, I was always curious about the world and I wanted to see deeper and understand more about it. I grew up during communist times and there were a lot of rules. We were never allowed to really question the teacher, and so that frustrated me. I came to the States when I was 15, and the high school that I went to, I had really incredible teachers. I very well remember my chemistry teacher. Oftentimes, someone would ask him a question, and then he says, "I don't know. Silvi probably knows. Do you know the answer?" And it's this treatment as an equal that was incredibly stimulating, and that's why I wanted to continue my education in the States. In my lab, we study this molecule called RNA that is, in my mind, the most incredible molecule. The deadliest viruses actually store their genetic material as RNA. The pandemic has been an extreme cause for urgency in the lab. We really felt like our research can really matter right now, and we were literally working nonstop. With my daughter, I'm trying to teach her that hard is great, that hard means you're pushing yourself beyond your limits. The difference between an average scientist and a great scientist is who gets up once getting kicked too many times. I want my work to matter, and I am definitely most proud of my students. If you inspire other people, you suddenly become so much more. I want to be those shoulders for other people to stand on and see further.